Good morning, everyone. Suburban Sentinel here. Welcome back to our series entitled Gentlemen's Rules. And in the last couple of episodes, we've been discussing men's hats. If you haven't seen those, I encourage you to watch them, and I will leave the links to those videos in the description box below. Today, we are getting started talking about hat etiquette. And I'm probably going to break the etiquette portion of this series up into a few parts because there are a lot of rules. So let's get started. And I hear the cat ready to jump up and disturb me already. As far as rules go, I'm already breaking one of them. I am wearing a hat inside a dwelling house, which is a no-no, but my wife will forgive me because this is only for the purposes of the video. And today we will focus on wearing hats kind of out in public, out on the street. So let me get rid of the cat if possible, and we'll get started. The vast majority of rules about men's hats revolve around two distinct actions, and those are doffing and tipping. And doffing a hat is removing it. Now, tipping a hat is quite a simple process. You're going to, using your right hand, grab the front of the brim of your hat with either your thumb and index finger or thumb, index, and middle finger, and simply pull the hat up off your forehead slightly and replace it. So that's a very simple, straightforward maneuver. Not rocket science. First, let's talk about hat tipping and ladies that you may see out on the street. The traditional rule is that a gentleman would tip his hat to every adult woman he passed along a public thoroughfare. And to me, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that rule. It's very traditional. I don't follow it anymore. Quite simply, it's impractical. If you live in a more densely populated area, you'd be tipping your hat every 2 seconds. It just really doesn't work out. The more modern guideline, which I tend to follow, is that a gentleman tips his hat to any adult female he would be inclined to say hello to, a friend or acquaintance if you're passing along a public thoroughfare. Note that this rule only applies if you're just passing by. If you're going to stop and chat with an adult female, the absolute rule is that you must doff or remove your hat. Also note that this hat tipping guideline applies to adult males that you pass along the street, as well as adult females. So the general rule becomes that if you're walking along a public thoroughfare, tip your hat to all adults who are either a friend or an acquaintance. Now, the difference between tipping your hat to men and women is that when you do a stop and chat when there's no women present, if it's just guys, one need not doff his hat in most circumstances. But we'll talk about that later. It's also proper to tip your hat contemporaneously with saying certain phrases such as hello, goodbye, acknowledging someone, asking to be excused, saying thank you, and you're welcome. So here are some examples in circumstances where a gentleman tips his hat. If you are on the street and walk up to a group of male friends, you would, of course, tip your hat. When taking leave of the same group of friends, when you say goodbye, tip your hat. if you are being introduced to someone that you have not met before, again, tip your hat. If you bump into someone accidentally and you would say, excuse me, again, tip your hat. And if you're bumped into and someone says, you know, I beg your pardon or excuse me, just tip your hat in acknowledgement. If you're saying thank you to someone, again, tip. And if you want to say you're welcome, you can tip your hat contemporaneously with that phrase as well. Essentially, it's a sign of respect, and there's nothing wrong with it. Tip generously, as they say. The hat police aren't going to come get you for tipping at the wrong time. Why is it that men tip their hats? Well, this is a custom that evolved along with the military salute. Back in the Middle Ages, when knights wore armor with those full-face helmets with the visor, a knight, to show that he was not a threat to someone he met in passing, would pull up his visor. And that was for two reasons. One, he would identify himself, showing his face, and two, by using his right hand, that's where the tradition of the right hand came into play, because most people were and are right-handed, it showed that you did not have your hand on a weapon. So essentially, it was a gesture of friendliness, and both saluting and tipping your hat mimics the gesture of raising a visor. So that's the basics of hat tipping. Next up, we will have more on hat etiquette, and we'll get more into doffing hats and the circumstances where that is appropriate. Thanks for watching. This is the Suburban Sentinel. Please thumbs up and subscribe if you like what you see. Questions and enlightening comments are always welcome. Bye, everybody.